Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam amma ba'da. Habita fillah, continuing on in our study of the methodology of the Salaf al-Saleh and the Ummah's need for it. We were talking about the Siratullahi al-Mustaqim, the straight path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Shaykh was mentioning some benefits from Suratul Fatiha. And he was in the last part of the surah and he said, "Wala dhalin," nor the path of those who went astray. Meaning that we want to follow the sabil al-mu'mineen, the straight path, and not resemble those people who went astray, nor those people who are misguided, and not to resemble those who had knowledge but did not practice, nor resemble those who are misguided, which refers to the is a reference to the Christians, as the Mufassirin stipulate. These are the people who worship Allah upon ignorance and deviation. So that means Muslims can end up resembling the Jews and the Christians in this in these manners, in that the one who worships Allah based upon ignorance and deviation, that they say they're Salafi but they don't know what Salafi is and they stay upon ignorance, that this is a resemblance of, this is making some sort of tashbih to the Christians. He said, these are the people who worship Allah upon ignorance and deviation. They worship Him and seek nearness to Him, but in a manner that is not legislated, and by the way of an incorrect path. They act upon innovation without proof from the Quran or the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Wakullu bid'atin dalala." All innovation is misguidance. So there was no exception. This is what the Christians are upon. And likewise, every person who adopts their path, everyone who worships Allah in a manner that is not legislated and correct, is astray and his actions are void. Very important. When the Shaykh says their actions are void, he means their actions of bid'ah, which, it means their actions of bid'ah. It does not mean that all of their actions, every act of worship, is astray, but rather when you say that their actions are not accepted or void, this refers to those people, it refers to the actions of bid'ah that they're involved in. Because as long as someone is a Muslim and has good, then their actions bi'idhni Allah will be accepted by Allah, except that which has bid'ah, because the Prophet ﷺ said, "Kullu bid'atin dalala wa kullu dalalatin fi an-nar," and every misguidance is in the fire. And the Prophet ﷺ said, "Man amala amalan laysa alayhi amruna fahuwa rad." Whoever does an action which is not in accordance with this affair of ours, will have it rejected. Letting us know that action is rejected if it's not in accordance with the sabil al-mu'mineen, with the book of Allah, the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the minhaj of the Salaf of this Ummah. That otherwise it will be rejected. Their action of worship will be rejected because it must conform and fit those criterion. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us with success in that. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Then the Shaykh says, this, the supplication at the end of the Surah Al-Fatiha, is a comprehensive supplication which we repeat in every unit of prayer. We must reflect over the meaning of this supplication and use it by supplicating with conscious hearts. We likewise must know its meaning so that our supplication will be answered. After reciting this surah, we say, Ameen. We say, Ameen. The meaning of Ameen is, O Allah, answer our call, meaning answer our supplication. Thus, this is a tremendous supplication for the person who contemplates and reflects. So you should reflect and ponder over the Quran. Reflect and ponder when you're reciting Surah Al-Fatiha. Try to ponder over its powerful meaning that you are, and put your heart into it, because you're supplicating to the one you've never seen. Hadha ilm al-ghayb. We only know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from His ayat in His creation, His ayat kawniyah, and His ayat shar'iyyah, meaning what's mentioned in the Quran and the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's how we know who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is. It isn't just a feeling. It isn't just an intuition. It isn't just this and that and the other, but rather it is through the various forms that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made His signs and verses for us to know that He subhanahu wa ta'ala exists, and He subhanahu wa ta'ala should be worshipped, and so we should implore Him. To implore is like to beg. We don't want to beg any person for something. Even when you're struggling, maybe you're struggling and you're totally poor, impoverished, you find that to be humiliating to beg before. But your Lord, you should actually find esteem from begging Him. And you've never seen Him. Crying to Him, asking His forgiveness, asking for His favor, asking for your needs, relying upon Him, worshiping Him in humility, and you will find strength and honor in that. Unlike if you give these same, you implore the people of this dunya, you implore others, you find humility, and that's all. You're humiliated. You don't find esteem in that. Who feels good about begging and asking someone for something? But here you're asking for favor. You're asking for your health. You're asking for an increase in your wealth. You're asking for all. You're asking for your the health of your family and the guidance of yourself and creation. And you're asking from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala these things. The Shaykh said, as we've previously mentioned, the person who traverses the path of those who have been blessed will be tested. He will be confronted with restriction. He will be belittled, called a deviant, and threatened, and thus he needs to be patient. It is for this reason. Narrations have mentioned that the individual who adheres to his religion during the latter days will be similar to the one holding on to a hot coal. This is because he will be confronted with trials and harm. He will receive harm by way of the people. Consequently, he must be patient, just as the person who holds a hot coal. This path will not be a bed of roses, as they describe it. Rather, it has many harms and difficulties. This path has harm by the way of the people. So you must be patient and firm upon it until you meet your Lord, the Mighty and High, while you are still upon it. This must be done in order that you may be saved from the hellfire. You will be saved from deviation in this life and saved from the hellfire in the next life. There is no path to salvation except this path, and there is no salvation except for the one who traverses it. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and bless us to be of those who are saved from the hellfire and to be from the Firqat al-Najiyah, the saved sect. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.